Shalom. I'm Felicity Elaine, the owner and creator of The Rebel Christian Publishing, and today I want to talk to you about the ultimate villain in Christian fantasy. Is it the devil? How do you write the devil into your stories? And does he fall into the pure evil trope? These are questions we're going to answer in this video, and please keep in mind it is part of a series, so if you missed part one, writing villains in Christian fantasy, I suggest you catch up on that. The link will be in the description box below. Before we get started, I always begin my videos with a prayer, so if my brothers and sisters in Christ don't mind joining me. Dear Heavenly Father, forgive us all for all of our sins. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for each and every viewer you have brought to this video. I'm so happy, Lord, to be able to talk about this topic. Holy Spirit, I ask that you guide us in this conversation. Speak through me and speak to me, Lord Jesus, and let everyone who watches this be blessed in their writing journey. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. So, let's get started. Welcome, those of you who've been there before, welcome back. Every single video on this channel, every single video on this channel has a companion article on my blog, which you can find at therebelchristian.com. So both the companion article and this video was inspired by a question that I received from a fellow viewer, a Christian writer, who was kind of wanting to discuss the pure evil trope and whether or not the devil is a cheesy character, a cheesy villain, or if he just kind of has a bad rep. And so that conversation and those emails that we sent back and forth was just all the material that I used into writing this and producing this video. So first, let's talk about the pure evil trope. What is the pure evil trope? And this happens in secular fiction and in Christian fiction together. So it doesn't matter whether you believe in the Bible or not. It's something that's out there. But the pure evil trope is a character, typically a villain, you know, the antagonist of the story that is evil for the sake of being evil. He's the ultimate bad guy, the demon warlord, I don't know, but he's just like really bad. And he has no motivation for it. He has no reasoning. He's one of those guys who just wants to take over the earth because he wants to take over the earth. And so the question is for Christian writers, well, is Satan the epitome of the pure evil trope? Is he evil for the sake of being evil? And in having conversations with that author, we kind of both came to the conclusion that no, he's not the epitome of the pure evil trope. That's what he has been portrayed as. But as we go through the article and continue through the video, we'll learn that there's actually a lot more to the devil's character, and that is really for you to unlock as a Christian author with guidance from the Holy Spirit to kind of walk you through the process of properly presenting the devil. So this isn't to say that you need to put Satan in your work, but I have read stories by Christian authors. One in particular, I don't remember the name of it. When I think of it, I'll put the information in its respective place somewhere on the screen, where it's about a young girl who actually had to go into hell to rescue her friend. And so I think she was guided through hell by an angel, and she went through the different levels of hell, and on each level there was one of the seven deadly sins. So she was, you know, facing pride and facing the temptation of lust, and she was facing gluttony, you know, as you go down and down. And so I don't remember if at the end she ultimately had to defeat the devil, but it was a pretty cool story and a pretty interesting concept. So the devil can certainly have a place in your writing as a Christian. There's nothing wrong with that. But we want to talk about, well, how do you avoid this pure evil trope? One of the best ways to avoid the pure evil trope, if you're writing about the devil in particular, is to know who you're writing about. This isn't to say that you must include every aspect of Satan, but it is to say that the traits that make him who he is should not be ignored. So let's very quickly go over the devil.
We know that he does have a personality. We know that he has a backstory. We know that he has many names, and that's very interesting to explore. In the same way, exploring the names of God brings you to a different face of God and a different strength of God with each revelation. It's kind of the same thing with the devil. I think exploring the names of the devil, and especially exploring his backstory, definitely adds a layer of depth to that character that you're not going to see in secular fiction. And when you do see it in secular fiction, it tends to be glorified. We talked about glorifying sin in our last video, writing villains in Christian fantasy, where we kind of have seen an uprising in dark forces in our fantasy, especially for young adults, things like witchcraft and sorcery being the good magic, the source for good and the light in the world. We've become familiarized and we have normalized the concept of the good witch, whereas 20, 30, 40, 50 years ago, that was not a thing. Other than possibly the Wizard of Oz, the Glinda the Good Witch, I think is who she is. The concept of a good witch really wasn't something that we tossed around, and now it's kind of, it is what it is. Witches are good, sorcerers are good, witchcraft is amazing. That's what we're seeing in our media. And so when you do see an introduction of Satan's backstory in secular media, he tends to be glorified. He's no longer represented as this corny, pure evil villain. He's now this mastermind, this super evil genius. And it's just kind of like, it's wrong and it's very twisted. So I actually believe the only people who can properly represent and properly portray the character of the devil is a Christian, because we know who he is and we know how to represent him from the Word of God. Most importantly, we know how not to glorify him. We understand that Satan is a defeated foe, and so we're not going to make him into this sexy, evil, genius, mastermind, overlord. We're going to make him who he is, you know, a betrayer of the brethren, a liar. We're going to expose him for the failure that he is, and we're also going to use Satan's story to glorify God. And that's kind of leading a little bit into our next video, which is, what is our job as a Christian author? What I'm building up to is that I believe that Satan has fallen into this pure evil trope because he has been consistently portrayed the wrong way, because the only cast that he's been given, the only screen time that he's been given, is by people who don't really know who he is. Only a Christian would truly know who Satan is, his motivations, how he works. Okay, and that's because we're filled with the Holy Spirit and we have been, you know, trained to recognize that demon when we see it, because it's God speaking through us and speaking to us. And once you become saved under grace, you're living as a child of God. It's so easy for someone in the light to recognize darkness. And people who don't really believe in God and don't really believe in the devil have a really hard time portraying God and portraying the devil because they don't know them. They don't know who or what they're talking about. And so Satan has kind of fallen into this pure evil trope where he's just evil for the sake of being evil, when in fact he's not. And to understand who Satan is and to understand his goal and his motivation and his backstory, you have to read the Bible, because that's where Satan originates from. He's not this mythological creature told and found out on like cave paintings in some ancient archaeological site. No, he's a fallen angel. He is real. But we as believers are the only ones who can truly understand that and believe it, and then depict that and portray that in our writing the correct way. Not only can we portray Satan as his true self, but we can do it without glorifying him. We can, in portraying Satan correctly, you then allow God to be portrayed correctly, because it is the ultimate evil of Satan that's defeated by the ultimate power of God. So I actually think, even if you're not writing the devil, it's important for us as Christians to understand the devil, because understanding the devil's power allows us to then further glorify and uplift the power of God. So I think that that about wraps this up. This is probably a shorter video than what I normally make, but I don't really want to dwell too much on the topic because it's kind of about the devil, and also because there's a lot more information in the article. So if you want to have a further discussion on this and you want more information on this as a Christian author or a Christian reader, I always recommend reading the companion article to this video on my blog, therebelchristian.com, which you can find the link to this specific article in the description box below. Don't forget that this is a part of a video series. We're talking all about unorthodox characters in Christian writing. So our first video to set off the series was writing villains in Christian fantasy. Today we talked about the pure evil trope and the ultimate villain that is Satan in Christian fiction. And I believe next video will probably touch on our jobs as Christian authors. What is the purpose of writing in these characters? Are you glorifying sin? Or are you just doing something because it's cool to you? I think that's something that we really need to talk about. And that goes along with our conversation that we'll eventually have, probably involving Christians reading Harry Potter, Christians writing LGBT characters into their work. Each video is built upon the last one, and so we're just kind of culminating into this climax of information. Okay. But thank you guys so much for this time that you've given me. If you've made it this far, you might as well join the family. Like, comment, subscribe, turn your notifications on, blah, blah, blah. I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, God bless.